coordinates for PB and Drac.
Already put my rucksack in the kitchen. I'll hang out there if that's okay.
Yeah, kitchen is fine.
And I'm in one of the escape pods. More my speed. That's fantastic. Welcome aboard. Any thoughts, Ryder?
Work it out. Whatever is cool. And I have nonchalant this is.
You're professionals. I'm not going to babysit bunk assignments. Let's talk about our success on Eos. Besides establishing our first viable outpost, we did some amazing things. We discovered the Remnant and breached their vault.
And didn't get killed.
Overcame radiation poisoning a number of times.
And didn't die.
Confronted by Ket at every turn.
And killed them all.
Not get killed.
You guys need to raise the bar on what you call success.
Yeah, should we use the Krogan definition of success that got your homeworld nuked by your own
people? Yeah, please.
Fair enough.
Antagonize him.
Let's focus. Back to the task at hand. Looking forward.
Exactly. Here's my only question. When do we hit that next vault? It looked active. We have to get on that.
Hang on. We need to not go off half-cocked.
There are initiative priorities. The team calls the shots.
Actually, the Pathfinder calls the shots, just to be clear.
I do. And I will.
So what do you need from us, Ryder?
Just get along and work hard. Both! I actually need both.
Let's be kind and give each other the benefit of the doubt. Finding a home for tens of thousands in this hellscape is stressful enough without adding dysfunction.
You got it, boss.
It's so nice to be a sociology major.
If Krogan are known for one thing, it's getting along.
Oh, yes.
Not humility or self-awareness. Okay.
I like Krogan.
Back to the Nexus. PB, Drac, see Lexi for a physical. Good meeting, everyone.
Oh, I'm so clueless. Augment! Augmentations are rare materials that can be added to some blueprints. Items incorporating augments can be more powerful or behave differently. I already knew that, unfortunately. Or fortunately, depending on how you look at things. No calls available at this time, that's unfortunate. Or fortunate, if you don't enjoy speaking with people. Let's see. Ah, there it is. Our first gem.
Strike team, ready for deployment.
Lexi!
Start running those.
Good idea. I know I'll need a refresher.
Just a tip. If you need to evac in deep space, you're probably not coming back.
Only if you don't know the drill.
Well, you guys are getting on like bees in a pea pot.
So we have a stowaway.
You mean PB?
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods. You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
Nope. I did not need a psychology degree. Thank you for offering to. Crew morale, tell me about it. I want to hear all about...
How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality.
Or violate away.
Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
Tell me more about your sorting method.
Why do you sort them that way?
Just easier for me to see patterns in behavior.
Alright, so tell me about the human crew.
How do you think the human crew members are handling things?
There's a lot of them.
True enough. Tell me about Cora. She is, let me guess, taking it hard that she's not the Pathfinder.
How's Cora doing?
She's processing. Your father was her mentor.
Exactly.
She expected to follow in his footsteps, but he gave the role of Pathfinder to you. Just because she trusts his judgment doesn't mean she's not confused. Or hurt.
See, I know what I'm talking about. Psychology.
How's Liam?
A handful. Every time I patch him up, he breaks something new.
Sounds like Liam.
Liam's "we can't lose" attitude is commendable. But I worry how he'll react when something does go wrong.
He'll explode. And maybe his hair will catch fire, if we're lucky. How about Gil?
Gil?
Gil likes to use humor as a defensive technique.
Don't we all?
He'd rather bury himself in the Nomad than tackle emotions head on.
Hmm. How about...
Suvi okay?
Yeah.
She's remarkably adaptive. I'm kind of jealous.
Well, you and me both, sister.
I'd like to check in on the non-human crew.
Ask away.
Tell me about PB.
Is PB all right?
She's been...
She's avoiding me. Probably thinks I'll poke her with a needle if she gets too close.
To be fair, you're always giving me shots.
Not in the hallway.
That... Is that true? Is it? I don't know. At any rate, she's only been here for 5 minutes, so I expect a further amount of information next time I ask. How about Drac?
Good?
That old bastard's always good. I've never met anyone who can be so stubborn and so appreciative. Could you look out for him, Ryder?
Sure thing. With pleasure, actually.
Don't worry,
he
Leslie.
Is so far
we'll
my
keep an eye on him.
Probably my favorite.
Thank you. And
guy.
Maybe don't mention I asked.
Oh, you have a thing for Krogan. That explains why you. Hey, he's your patient as well. Oi. How about Vetra?
Tell me about Vetra.
Vetra's used to having someone depend on her. I think that's why she's so resourceful and likes providing for other people. That being said, I think she could use a little me time.
And who the hell is Kalo? Ah, yeah. The pilot.
How's our Solarian?
He's quite the gossip.
Oh.
Tight-lipped about himself, though.
My man, I'm surprised.
Thanks
Anything
for the
else?
Insight.
Oh, yeah, sure. I'm going to ask you about becoming a doctor. Tell me everything.
How did you get into medicine?
My mum was a dancer on Omega. Dad was a bouncer. I'd patch him up after busy nights. Discovered I had steady hands. They put every credit they earned into my education.
Are they here in Helios?
No. Both died in a turf war. Made leaving the Milky Way behind easier.
I understand. And instead of giving you some words of comfort, I'm going to go ahead and say, see you around, because I cannot deal with emotion.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
These moments have always struck me as so weird. So weird. Anyway, let's sell all the salvage. Nice. That's loads of money. LODSOFMUNY. What's it spell? Loads of money. Probably. So, where exactly did... Kitchen. Oh yeah, kitchen. Where the hell is this, the kitchen? Somewhere below. Right. Those are my quarters. That's the bathroom. Could find a crew in here, I suppose. Crew info board. Getting new. Lost and found coffee mugs. Found a mug yesterday near the biolab. Nice one with a magnetized base. You left it stuck sideways to a bulkhead. That's mine. I just put it down for a sec when my hands were full. Next time, maybe empty it first. Wise advice. Very, very wise. The search for a lost kitchen is always difficult. Hey, Liam.
I hear this joker beat you at poker too. Where'd you hear that?
The little Brody told her.
A floating Brody.
It was a close game.
It did give me a better game than Drac. Not saying much.
Watch it.
Forget him. Let's get a game going with everyone else.
Hey, that's like playing Catan with your best friend.
No thanks. I need my creds. And my clothes. And both my kidneys.
I actually like the banter so far. Medbay. Crew quarters. Is it here then?
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan.
Who were you talking to?
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
She's your granddaughter? What? You really are an old man, aren't you? Well.
Well, welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
I like the way you think, kid.
I do too.
Someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
Probably Tan. Damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
It's hard to be on your own, probably.
Leaving the Nexus can't have been an easy choice.
It was, actually. Staying became impossible. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony.
And what happened to your colony?
Bad consequences all around.
And what about Kesh? She chose to stand behind. Did you try to persuade her to come with you?
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Rushan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to.
True.
As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
I do understand why he left. I really do.
Your people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority.
That's awesome.
That's why I'm happy to tag along and help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Can't argue
Hospitability
with that.
Is always a plus. Let's see. Got any interesting trivia you'd like to share?
Ryder, you meet Strander yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Assistant Director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around. Spender lied to the Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for Kesh ever since.
Oh, I heard about him.
I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
I would like that.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh is my Rushan, child of my blood. Raised her myself. Damn proud of her, too. She did good, even with me for a granddad.
I like her. She is unusual for a Krogan.
She's honest. Definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
True enough. What about Sam? What do you think about artificial intelligence?
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and squad connectivity yet?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to my comms, sure, but that's where it stops.
That's fine.
Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
Why?
Why do you say that?
I've seen what bots can do when they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights. There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah, my peacekeeping career went up in smoke when news of what my dad was researching got out.
No shit. Ruined the writer name, I'll bet.
It did. Well, as much as I dislike it, Sam and I are a package deal.
Sam is part of what makes someone a Pathfinder. You're just going to have to deal with that.
So long as it's not in my head and it ain't messing with my body.
Tell me about yourself, Druk.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
Vetra.
How did you and Vetra meet?
Oh, yeah. Huh, my companion.
That's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late, didn't he? Must have been a pretty steep learning curve since they thawed you out.
You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were building the Nexus. She swiped supplies I was trying to get for Kesh right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit from no one.
I'm inclined to believe that.
I have no problems believing that.
Yeah, she told me off good. But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Kesh's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Kesh all along. They're both still laughing at me over that.
That explains why you respect her so much. Krogan Colony, tell me more about it. I'm very curious to know where exactly it is. What's going on with it?
Krogan Colony.
What kind of world they inhabit?
There. We also got some scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up. Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable, the works. Even some farming.
Farming? Krogan farm?
So you
food,
Krogan
food.
Manage
just because
to
we can eat anything doesn't
get up and running.
For scraps.
And the Nexus, supposedly with more resources than
myself.
You.
Takes a while to chew through those.
He's been waiting for me all along. That's insane. How about your combat experience? Where is that from?
So, about all this combat experience you have, I'd love some details.
Ha! Sure, the list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have. I've been doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit, well over 1,000 years. Don't even know how I'm still alive.
1,000 years? Are you lying to most ancient Krogan yet?
Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck. And a really hard head.
That's impressive. War stories. Nexus surprising. Tell me more about it. I'm trying to picture...
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the
mutiny. To paint a picture in my head,
more like. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station business. Spender, Addison's assistant, lied about the deal. And Tan came down hard. Too hard.
I'll deal with it.
So we left.
I'll deal with Tan.
She's alone on that station now.
You're worried about her.
You think someone might try to hurt Kesh?
Huh. More like she airlocks Spender. Or he tries to stab her in the back, and then she airlocks him. Tan wouldn't listen to me when I told him Spender had a part in the mutiny. I had no proof.
So what's my part in this?
Things need to get sorted out, and my clan needs to get back on station without Spender messing things up.
And I understand that.
The way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
I'll make it happen.
Got any stories?
Spender is now public enemy number one.
Does a pie jack scratch its butt?
Any combat advice?
Anything about the cat? Or combat in general?
Well, common cat are pretty straightforward. Hit them hard enough, they die like anything else.
Anything else?
Tell me more about fighting cat.
Wraiths are sneaky little shits, like to ghost up behind you when you least expect it.
I noticed that.
Just listen for them. They tend to give themselves away right before coming
at you. I'm too busy speaking to listen.
Break through their head plates, then a headshot should do the trick.
Perfect. Well,
we can talk more later.
Talk to you later,
sure.
Mate. I'll argue.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
Do you call everyone kid?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Ha, when you get to be my age.
I don't mind him calling me a kid. If I were 1,000 years old, I would call everyone a kid. All the time. Better beginning. We'll do this in a moment.
Where's
last thing?
You're setting up in here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault. If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus.
You have
this
personality?
This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Not sticking around.
Should I consider you a temporary addition?
Everything's temporary, Ryder. I get it.
That's a warm and fuzzy way to look at
it. You're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Exactly.
Something like that? Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
You grab excitement, huh? Well. You crave excitement, huh? Boredom drove you here. You should try sleeping more. Let's go with the romance option.
Tackling complete strangers in the Milky Way wasn't doing it for you?
I think tackling you anywhere would be fun. Did I say that out loud? Life won't be boring with you around. I may never yawn again.
So Bolden drove you here, I suppose?
You left everything and everyone you knew because you were bored?
No.
Sounds like me, actually.
I came with someone I knew. Then she got bored with me.
Oh.
Ryder,
sorry about
that. Milky Way was so... been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
That sounds... kind of... cliche, but I like it. I like you, PB. And I am constantly trying not to call you Phoebe.
Well, congratulate yourself. No one has ever so successfully dodged my attempts to get to know them.
Yes! I'm number one! Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth.
Oh my.
Then again, I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned, which you're gonna love, by the by.
Am I?
Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
Don't I have some of that tasty little Remtech? Let's see if I have anything for you.
Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
Yes, I do. But first, I'd like to hear about your current project.
You really won't tell me what you're working on?
That's right. Next question.
The Tempest crew.
How do you like the team?
Interesting bunch. I get a good feeling from Vetra. Not your typical military-minded Turian.
Dang,
Liam seems a lively
demons
one.
Demons for
that. I expect he'll surprise me. Drek is, well, old. Wonder if he can still learn new tricks.
Well, if he was a dog...
Gil smacks of complication. Might take some unraveling. Callow and Suvi seem busy. Hope they aren't all work, work, work. Who's left?
Well, there's...
Oh, right, Cora. What's her deal? Is she as prim and proper as she comes across?
My turn to talk. Well...
Oh, is it my turn to talk?
Sorry. Yeah, I should work on my motor.
You might find that people reveal themselves more freely if you give them a chance. Cora included.
Really good advice.
There's also Lexi,
our doctor. Welcome.
She's an Asari.
Oh, I'll get around to her. All in all, seems like a decent bunch.
What is it about Lexi that worries you? Let's see, the Nexus. The Nexus, yes, that place. Oh.
What was it like for you on the Nexus?
Well, I wasn't supposed to be woken up yet. A resourceful accomplice finagled my early thaw.
Oh?
So I kind of lived off the grid. Snuck around, bullshitted my way onto excursions off station. After I found my first remnant ruin,
have to be resourceful for that.
Borrowing shuttles.
Oh.
After that, I didn't spend much time on the Nexus. I even missed most of the revolt.
I think you're lucky. Oh, let's speak flirting.
What does someone have to do to get you to flirt with them?
Not much at all. But I get a little extra jolt when I'm matched wink for wink. So just be yourself and the flirts will flow.
Fantastic. I will do that.
You mentioned you came to Andromeda with someone.
Nothing gets by you. Guess that's why you're the Pathfinder. Just a friend. The one who woke me up early. But now she's not even that. It's better to venture into the unknown without restraints or entanglements, don't you think?
Sounds kind of lonely, I won't lie.
I don't know. Don't friends and loved ones make all the effort worthwhile?
I've always been self-motivated. Don't need much more than curiosity to drive me forward.
I can get behind that.
What drew you to the Remnant?
Are you kidding? It's evidence of a sophisticated species no one knows anything about. It doesn't get more intriguing than that.
Or more Mass
Effect
1.
Discover. I want to be the first to figure them out. And the tech... It's on a different scale. If we can appropriate it, who knows what advances we'll make.
It is very impressive.
You're off the hook, PB. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. Don't be a stranger.
I never am. Should I speak with anyone else? Maybe Cora? Yeah. Maybe I should speak with Cora. Let's... Well, my hands, I can see through them. Oh, the horror. Crew quarters, medbay. What on earth was Cora? Oh, I think I know. Not here. Let's take the elevator. Or maybe speak with Liam while I'm at it. He passed through a box.
Prodromos. Prodromos. Sounds good, doesn't it? We saw
Suppose
it, Pathfinder.
So.
A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
I'm not interested in you. I'm kind of interested in Peewee for now.
Just wondering what you think of how I'm doing at the job.
I'm committed
to
the initiative.
I wonder if I can be interested in a 1,000-year-old Krogan.
It's as simple as it gets.
Oh well, I suppose we'll find out soon enough. About you, what about you? What is it about you that makes me want to punch you?
Tell me something about yourself.
Alright, I was a bad student, piss poor cop, great responder. Had a good life, but it all been done. I wasn't looking to start over.
Might be the accent.
Start big.
Something about the accent.
You're a cop, then
Christ's
response?
Maybe I'm jealous. Probably not.
Long in either.
Didn't have the patience for law, so I figured enforcement. Dad knew it didn't fit before I did. But it got me into hustle. They mostly take vets and retired service. Best years of my life.
Yeah, it does. It seems cliche. You seem cliche.
Procedure. That's overdone.
I know, right? I wanted new, and I got it. And that led me here.
And what about your family?
Tell me.
I don't know
family.
Why I'm asking,
I'm
since I don't care.
Some nights you just cry, right?
Oh.
That's the thing everyone does.
Why the hell did
Mom,
you come?
Mom, Joelle, Dad, Calvin. Both lawyers. Met on the Citadel, settled on Earth. No brothers or sisters. That...
Well, sorry to say, probably dead.
It was traditional.
Like 600 years ago. Sadly non-traditional. Probably.
Life with my family was not typical on a number of fronts.
You make do though, right? Family has to. I know mine did.
Well,
I said goodbye to my mum and dad and got on a ship to Andromeda.
Charming story.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
Do you now? Didn't you get a couch just to sit on said bloody couch? So why the hell are you sitting not on couch? Oi, there used to be a Tyrion here. Where she's gone off to? When you lose a Tyrion, it sucks. Big time. Ballop.
Report from the Nexus. Population's growing as people wake up. Lots of hopefuls waiting for a home.
Bradley will have all the help he can take.
They'll be starting crops soon.
Yum. I guess.
Can't tell if they have enough water or too much.
Too much water is never
I
bad.
I grew up on a little cargo freighter.
Oh.
Only saw gardens in
bits. It is. Of course it is.
I always loved them. I daydreamed about planting a big rose garden when we got here and still imagine it sometimes. Roses in Helios.
It'd be good to bring something beautiful across galaxies.
Everyone in the initiative has their something beautiful. I didn't for a while. After I left the Asari Commandos, well, I didn't leave. My mentor, Nasira, said
Why?
I should go.
What
Why?
Happened?
The initiative would suit you better, was all she said. Being a huntress suited me fine, but she insisted.
Perhaps it was best for you?
It sounds like she cared more about what you needed than about what you wanted.
I didn't need to be rejected. Still, that's familiar. When your biotics are honed into huntress-grade weapons, people can be weird about it. The
people can be weird about anything and everything all the time.
Just didn't see how I'd fit into their brave new galaxy. I never fit anywhere before. Then I met some jerk named Ryder. Talked about traveling to Andromeda like he was teaching you how to see it.
What appealed to you?
What part of that vision made you want to take the plunge?
A civilization where everyone had a place, even AI, or an overpowered human biotic. Your father said, I get being different. Now imagine being welcome and making others like you welcome too. When I was 13, I could warp a steel girder. He made me wonder, what if someone had told me, that's okay?
It is okay. You should believe in your ability to warp things. Made of pure metal.
The whole expedition
and become Magneto.
Launched. Dad knew that.
He wouldn't be stalled by minor issues like credits or physics. So I gave the initiative my all. Kept thinking of the niche I wanted. My rose garden. I thought I knew what I was going to be.
This is about not taking over as Pathfinder?
Didn't think it would still sting. Nasira, your father, even my parents. They leave, I'm left without answers. Nowhere to stand.
Move on, Cora. You need to.
It sucks, but it happened. We need your mind on the mission.
Always is. But I'm human, too. Need time to find a way through. And if that remnant tech pays off, maybe someday I'll have roses, too.
What I am kind of unhappy about is that I tell her to move on, and I say it very calmly, and she responds just as calmly to what I say.
Strike team ready for deployment.
Oh, lovely. That strikes me as a little bit weird. Oh, I recovered an artifact. Let's see. Debrief. Yay, successful mission. Woohoo. I haven't got some loot boxes. Anyway, that's for me to see and for you to not. Let's go over to the Nexus. It was where I was supposed to go, first time around. Let's talk with Suvi before.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
Of course it is. It does have beauty.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful.
Darkly beautiful.
Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
Divine intelligence? A god?
You mean a god?
Yes. I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd, but I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
I feel the same way. There's no higher power. And these are the only two answers I can pick, which is insane. I should have at least four. At least. This is a complicated question and one shouldn't answer it with one of two binary possibilities. That's stupid.
There's nothing about the universe that suggests a divine intelligence. And most of what we've seen in Helios is artificial, as you said yourself.
Yes, but we're creative beings. Whoever made the remnant was too. Why should that be proof against a god? Wouldn't a true creator want to pass on the drive to invent?
Then why bother with science? Or believe what you want? Sure, believe what you want.
You are welcome to your beliefs. It's good to have different voices on the team.
Excellent. Oh, speaking of the team, I should update the folks back in the Nexus with the latest reports. We'll talk later.
Please do. Absolutely. Let's see, any emails asking for assistance? Dr. Aridana. Hello, Ryder. Forgive the intrusion. I have an issue that you and Sam should be able to readily solve. It may assist my investigation into the Scourge. We can discuss it in person. The vault. Cora. Can still smell that remnant vault in my armor. Lot of weird shit down there. Like my Huntress manuals would say, the razor's edge between known and unknown teaches you what can be cut away. Now I think back, it reminded me a little bit of some of the temples in Tessia. Same huge spaces and running water. Same sense of a huge purpose you can't really understand. Makes me wonder if I will ever really know what their builders did there. Tempest Hawks. The Tempests. Alright, so that's my palette. Suvi. Dear Ryder, I'm grateful for our talk earlier. Even if we ended up disagreeing, debate can be invigorating. About your dad. Vetra told me what happened to your dad. I've lost a lot of people over the years. Figured... You know, Drag doesn't strike me as someone who writes... emails, but then again, I read this Drak has attached 37 images of various rifles and shotguns to duplicate images. Many are low res or watermarked. This usually helps him. That's cool. That's okay. That's fun. Derider from Lexi. Who the hell was Lexi? Yeah. All right. Carlo, you... Let's see if you will say something racist and horrible about...
Glad you stopped by.
...the Krogan.
You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector?
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
It's exhilarating.
I could stand here and drink in that view all day.
When I was test piloting the ship back home, I often did. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
I'm surprised that no one else thought as you did.
I get it. Like leaving a good story half finished.
The team liked that one of us was going. It felt right after all we went through. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion,
memories are precious.
Equations, tapping on the console. Three drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian arc missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
I'm sure we'll discover it. Any word on that, by the way?
Did you hear anything about the arc back on the Nexus?
Not a peep. Isn't that strange? You'd think there'd be something. Not that I dislike your company, but it's lonely without other Solarians.
There is Stan, I suppose. But I don't want to bring him up, because I have a fond disliking for his racism towards the Krogan.
Don't sweat it. We'll bring the Solarians home.
Of course we will. I just have to be patient, that's all. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time.
I will. I actually don't mind speaking with you. Right. Time to go to... I have no idea where I'm going. No clue whatsoever. Anything? Anything else? Nope. That's fair. Please leave. Perfectly fair. So much to do in the Nexus. Let's speak with Dan first, then get some momentum going.